Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. My name is Ashwini and today we are going to see 2016 supplementary KMA problem. I have already uploaded 2015 supplementary, 2016 all the question paper KMA problem with solution I have already uploaded, and if you need the link is given in the description box, you can check it out. So today we are going to see the 2016 supplementary paper question. So let us not waste the time and start the problem. Before that, if you have not subscribed my channel yet, please don't forget to subscribe my channel. Subscribe right now. Seeing the problem, first we have f of a, b, c and d. So wherever the term a, b and c, d, this term will be used in here as well as here, all the rows and columns. So this is the first step. So here you have written this thing. This is the first thing you are going to write. A bar B bar means it is 0 0. A bar B means 0 1. Wherever bar is there, A bar, in the place of bar you are going to write it 0. It means 0, bar means. Wherever bar is not there, that is 1. A B means 1 1. A B bar means A, B bar means 0, and here C bar D bar, that is 0 0, C bar D 0 1, C and D 1 1, C D bar 1 and 0. This is how you are going to enter the rows as well as column. Next step is you have 4 cross 4, so here you are going to enter the values. So that values are nothing but, so sigma means it is SOP, sum of product. So whatever the values we have here, that should be entered in this particular boxes. So this particular boxes need a number, a labeling, that we are going to do in the next step. So here the first one is 0, the second one is 1. Remember, you are not going to fill the third one. First you are going to fill the fourth column, that is 2, and then you are going to fill the this particular third one, that is 3. So this is how you are going to fill. Next, 4, 5, 6, 7. Next, leave this third row, come to the fourth row, 8, 9, 10, 11. Next, come to the third one, 12, 13, 14 as well as 15. This is the entry, or this is labeling the boxes. So this is how you are going to do. This is the next step. Next step is you have to enter the values in this particular box. Whatever the values given here, SOP means 1. Wherever this particular numbers are there, in that particular square you are going to enter 1. So first one is 1, so in the place of 1 you are going to place 1. Next it is 5, here 1. Next it is 9, here 1. Next it is 10, here 1. Next it is 11, here 1. 12, here 1. 13, here 1. 14, here 1. Okay, next, remaining all the boxes whatever we have there, you are going to place zeros. So place 0 here, 0, 0, empty boxes you are going to place 0. Okay, next step is grouping. So grouping, first step is check out whether you have octal. Octal means 8. Whether you have 8 ones, you need to check. In this particular problem, you don't have that particular thing. Go with quad. Quad means 4. Wherever you have 4 ones, you need to group it. So first one is this one. This is your first group, G1. Next, you don't have any 4 over here. So go with pair. So pair means, this is one of the pair, I'll group this as G2. Next you have one more here. So this I'll mark it as G3. Next, here you have one and here you have one. Here you can do overlapping. This as well as this overlapping. So this is one of the condition, and this overlapping I'll mark it as G4. So this G4, together it is G4. So this is how you are going to mark it. So next step is writing the expression. To write the expression, first I'll go with G1. Here you need to remember the common terms. So whichever the common terms you have, that you are going to enter. So G1. G1 is quad. So Q1 I'll mention, the first quad. So here you can see this line here. You don't have any common terms here, because here you have A bar, A bar, A, A. So A is not a common term. Here you have B bar, B, B, B bar. So here also you don't have. So here the common term is C bar, D, that you are going to write it over here. For this whole ones, this particular quad, the common term is C bar, D. So this is completed. Next go with G2, the group 2. So here group 2 is P1, that is your pair. So here you have pair here. Here you can see the common term for these two ones is A, B bar. So here go here. Here you have the common term is C. So that you are going to write it over here. Next, the P2, that is G3. So this particular pair, so this one. So for this both the ones, the common term is AB, right? And go with the column here. Both the column, the common term is C bar. So that you are going to enter it over here. Next we are going to see the G4, that is overlapping. Overlapping one, okay. So this as well as this. So for this both the term, AB is common. So I'll write AB, and for this the common term is D bar. So I'm going to enter D bar. So here we got the four terms. So now we are going to write the final expression. Final expression, f of a comma b comma c comma d is equal to, you are going to write all the four terms. So first group is c bar d plus this one a b bar c plus this one a b c bar plus this term a b and d bar. So this is the final expression. So this is the solution for this particular problem. So I hope you understood this particular problem. If you have any doubts, leave your doubt in the comment section. I'm going to answer it. If you like this video, please hit a like, share it with your friends, and please don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thank you.